customized skincare seems to be becoming more and more of a thing, and I will say I am intrigued.
My mama told me I was special, and sometimes I just want to feel special, okay?
Customized skincare seems nice, this idea that skincare is customized to you, that it's better for your face. I've heard about this in quite a few different places, and there seems to be some that are more over-the-counter and some that are actually prescription. Now, I have tried a few, such as Function of Beauty, Dermatica, and even Curology before, and honestly, if these brands can get it right, if we can figure out what our skin needs and actually tailor it to us, that sounds amazing. But does it cost a ridiculous amount of money? Is it just base formulas that they put a few extra ingredients in that really don't work? And do some of these quizzes actually ask you questions that help the brand understand and tailor products to your skin? Or if you don't know your skin type, are you in deep shit? And out of a lot of money? Again, I first heard about these kind of floating around online, but there seem to be more and more and more. And some other ones seem like they're really making innovations in sustainability, and some of them seem just straight up overhyped, overspoken about with questionable reviews. So, I am deciding to sacrifice my time, my face, and my wallet for you, and I'm gonna try out three of these like non-prescription customized skincare brands to see if they're actually customized, to see if they're any good, to see if the formulas are nice, if they're really customized to me, and whether or not they're worth it. There seem to be a whole bunch of these customized brands online, but the three that interest me most are the ones that I've seen on Shark Tank, the one that actually seems to be about sustainability, and this unique one that seems extremely overhyped. Here's what other people had to say about them.
I'm just gonna start off by Googling customized skincare. A lot of things come up, including this Proven one. It says $35. This is the one that I've seen literally all of the ads for. And I think that this is the one that was on Shark Tank. The testimonials and reviews on the website are all 5 out of 5, which is kind of scary because, you know, why is it all 5 out of 5, especially on your own website? I don't know. I'm a critic and a skeptic. They have very beautiful graphics, I must say. Cleanser, toner, and exfoliator in one. That reminds me of like those men's 7-in-1. Body wash, shampoo, deodorant, toothpaste, car oil, like all in one. Kind of scary, but if it is customized to you, does that work? People are saying it gets like 4.5 stars. This is like an article that's written by someone. Her before and afters are pretty compelling. I mean, it doesn't really count if you already have a nice face and you end with a nice face. Reddit, come to the rescue. Oh, and I hate it when I get pop-ups. Fuck off. Okay. Don't you just hate that, Bucky?
I went perusing the internet for other unbiased reviews off of the company's website, and for the most part, the general opinion seemed to be positive. Some Redditors did have positive things to say about their experience, while others were not shy to share their disappointment. Some people said that they felt the brand was gimmicky and it like followed some of the same patterns that other gimmicky or scammy skincare lines used, but with more of the active ingredients that I actually love to see. Some people said that the multifunctionality of the products helped them reduce the number of steps in their skincare routine, but others also said that they felt the products were low quality. One person said that the texture of the cleanser was like, quote, cheap hand lotion. One reviewer stated that they felt the quiz didn't ask enough relevant questions and they wished that they hadn't tried the line. I found that, like me, many other people are suspicious of the brand's website only displaying like the 5-star reviews.
Update, even though it was a rough start with such a drastic change in formulations that I'm used to, my skin is in the best shape it's ever been, no lie. Even the diffuse redness is gone. No more 8,463,747 steps for me! Well, you know, at least people actually got their items. At least it sounds like they were customized. Let's go take this quiz. 3 minutes to my best skincare. 3 minutes is something I can handle. Whose skin are we talking about? Should I put my name or should I put something else? Bucket? Buckmeister. How concerned are you with fine lines and wrinkles? A little.
They asked me further questions about my personal skin concerns, such as whether or not I'm concerned about wrinkling, skin thinning, or sagging of my skin in certain areas of my face. The quiz also asked questions about like the nature of my breakouts and blemishes. For instance, do I experience more blackheads or more whiteheads? Are they tender or inflamed, swollen bumps, or large red inflamed ones?
Here's my question. It's taking me through all of these, but it's almost relying on me knowing my skin or my skin type. And it's asking me questions about acne. I could see someone who has acne that's bad for them, but clinically it's not that bad, saying that they have horrific acne when it would be moderate. Or someone who's not really concerned about the appearance of their skin, saying that they have moderate acne when really it would be something that's more severe. So this quiz almost like relies on you actually knowing your skin type. Which could be wrong, but let's see. Yeah, a lot of room for subjective interpretation. Okay, it asks me, have you been diagnosed with any of these skin conditions? And it lists a bunch of them, but there's no button for no. They said it would take 3 minutes. I feel like this is taking a lot more than 3 minutes.
I answered more questions about the prominence of the capillaries on my face and even the effectiveness of my current skincare routine. They asked me how my skin looks when I wake up and how it looks in photos, which is actually really cool. The last few questions of this quiz asked about how my face feels after the shower, as well as how I personally identify my skin type and skin tone.
Oh my God, I didn't even realize on the side, wow, I'm a dumbass. On the side, it's actually with each of my answers, it's adding an ingredient. Oh my God, these are actually really cute. And I actually see ingredients I really like. Sea kelp bioferment, pre and probiotics, caffeine, willow bark, salicylic acid, tea tree oil, azelaic acid, green tea. Okay, wow. Where should we send results? Oh, they want my email. Note, if you don't have a spam email, set yourself up with a spam email. Buckmeister Fullerene, meet your custom skincare. Okay, you guys, get my... What I clicked on Google said $35 or $38. Oh. This is coming up at $185. And it says it's discounted to $119. How the f*** did we go from $38 to $119? Okay, let's just do the thing. Hang on, let me search proven skincare discount code. Give me a discount code feet. Up in here.
It smells like feet.
Okay. Promo no longer valid. Proven 20. 20, 21. God damn it. Proven 5 worked. Fuck yeah, we went from 119 to 113. My order is processing. Ouch, that was expensive. Watch my credit card company text me in like 3 minutes and be like, did you authorize this large purchase? Love from Yours is coming up at $79. I've had conversations on Discord with my beautiful butterfly family about this, so I am intrigued. This says, Love from Yours, free shipping, unlike proven skincare. Save 16 doll hairs on day and night set, 96 down to 79. It's a day and night set that has everything you need to fight skin concerns. And actually, when we look at the reviews on their own website, it's 4.6, it's not 5. That actually makes me trust it slightly more.
I moseyed my way over to an Australian skincare Reddit where I searched for some unbiased opinions on your skincare. People did express suspicion about social media skincare brands in general, and one person said that their MLM senses were tingling. But overall, it didn't seem like anyone had really tried the line yet.
No one seemed to try it, so I guess I'll be your guinea pig. Or genie in a bottle. Again, your wish is my command. Genie pig! Genie pig! I'm your genie pig. Okay.
One of these reviewers returned to the comments to provide an update after trying the line. They said that it didn't feel as personalized as other skincare brands that they had tried. They loved the night cream, but not the day moisturizer. Their final verdict was that it felt like a good and affordable option to try out custom beauty. Definitely excited to give this one a try.
Oh my God! The founder jumped on the Reddit and started answering questions. Wait, I'm kind of into this. It says, hi everyone, this is Navneet, founder and CEO of Yours. I'm here to answer your questions. Ah, since when do we have a founder on Reddit? This I respect. We are definitely not a faceless company, so I'm here to answer all of your questions. We are just a bunch of passionate folks on a mission to make skincare simple and sustainable. I've gone through a painful cycle of trial and error with skincare myself, only to realize it's not just our skin type, but also our lifestyle and environment. P.S. We are backed by globally reputed investors like Sequoia, GFC, and Jay-Z. And then she puts a picture of herself. Girl, you're cute. Wait, she actually lists a ton, like, varying review, like, from Facebook to, like, a news article to, like, YouTube to, like, their own website. They actually, she cited her sources. I'm gonna give this a try. This also has really pretty ingredients. Oh, I actually don't know this Swiss organic flour, but it says it reduces sebum production and supports pore size reduction, which we know that anatomically can't happen, but we can reduce the appearance of pores, so I'll let it slide. They actually have some pretty advanced plant actives. Day and night skincare set is $79. Oh, here's the subscriptions. Everything Yours, $195. Subscription Day and Night Set plus Cleanser, $112. Subscription Day and Night Set plus Eye Serum for $104. Oh, you know what? You're allowed to purchase the products individually. That's actually really nice. If I didn't want to purchase everything at once or get on a subscription, I like that I am given options. And it kind of looks like they're using real people on the website. They have a recycling guide at the bottom of the screen. We're on a mission to make skincare simple and sustainable, and we need your help with recycling. Here's how to recycle Yours the right way.
There is an entire page on this website that tells you exactly how to recycle this brand's products, which I feel is really commendable. They were telling me how to separate the internal component from the casing so that both could be recycled separately and properly. The page even had helpful diagrams and visuals for people like me who don't read instructions. It appears that all of Yours' packaging is recyclable if done according to their instructions. Their website tells you about their carbon footprint pledge to reduce emissions as well, and they even show you some recycling facts from around the world. I was just like, take my money. Just, here's my wallet. Help yourself.
My credit card company's gonna be so concerned. Name, Buckmeister. This is cute. Even here, as I'm personalizing it, it says, mostly age is just a number, but when it comes to your skin, it determines strength and resilience. I love the way that that is phrased. Thank you. How would you describe your cheeks in the morning? Which cheeks, my friends? You gotta be a little more specific. Acne, blackheads, whiteheads, wrinkles, age spot? Ever had an adverse reaction? Oh yeah, I have. It was orange essential oil. Ooh. Ooh, they wanna know more about my lifestyle.
I found that this quiz asks a lot of the same questions, but the one thing that I did love is that this one has little factoids along with each question to help the quiz taker understand why it's relevant to their skin. This quiz asked about my sleeping habits, but they even took it a step further with a fact about how sleep deprivation can affect your skin's collagen and elastin production, as if I needed a reminder. They told me about how my water consumption impacts skin elasticity, and I answered some more questions about my daily lifestyle factors, such as environment, diet, exercise, even my travel habits and alcohol consumption, both of which are zero. The quiz also asked questions about how often I wear makeup and whether or not I smoke.
Oh my god, I love that they give us facts about blood vessels. Ooh, now they want my environment. Seasonal changes. We auto update your routine as seasons change. WTF. Yeah. Here's the environment your skin is exposed to in Stanford, California. The UV index, the pollution, the humidity, and the temperature. Like, they legit know that it's raining outside right now.
It says that?
Yeah, and the temperature, it's exact. Bruh. Oh, here's my box, ready. Buckmeister Fullerene Skin Analysis. Vitals, hydration, good. Skin elasticity, appears to be good and youthful. Oxidative stress needs help. Here's what my skin needs. Oh, and it gives me options. And it says it lasts 2 months and I get free shipping. It says I have combination skin. I disagree, I have oily skin. But it does say that my skin is more acne and problem prone. Oh, they are blaming my moderate amount of stress on my excessive oiliness triggered by the stress hormone cortisol. Exactly, those adrenal glands have been working overtime. Again, even on the front of the brand's page, it's like clean skincare. And you know how I feel about clean skincare because skincare can't really be categorized into clean or dirty. It's kind of marketing. So that's kind of what scares me. But the fact that they look like they're actually backing up their environmental stuff and the quiz was halfway decent gives me a little bit of hope. But face yoga? face yoga. Now this is starting to sound like some crystal healing type of shit. There's this one girl on Instagram who's literally doing damage to people with face yoga and selling it as ads, like an 8-day course. That is for another video. But if you want it, comment. Remember, I am a genie in a bottle and your wish is my command. Oh, 95. Not bad. Day serum, moisturizer, night serum, night cream. It even says a gentle retinol serum with naturally occurring form of vitamin A, safe for sensitive skin types and first-time retinol users. It has Matrixyl, which is great, wonderful peptide. Very interesting. Buckmeister Fullerene's moisturizer. Wow, Epidermist, it has Sebosha. When we look at the full ingredients, we do have glycerin, propandiol, dimethicone. I assume this is going to be very nice. It does have fragrance. If this were truly customizable, I feel like you could remove that. Really nice with these ferments. But, yeah. Night serum has Alps sebum, Sebosha, niacinamide, which we love. Again, seems like a halfway decent base that they're adding these ingredients into. Ooh, do I want to add the Cloud Factory cleanser? Maybe I do. Sunny Side Up. Ooh, a sunscreen! A water-based broad sunscreen SPF 30 for all-day UV and blue light protection. It is a Juvenol A filter, but it has some other stuff, such as Juvenol MC80. Okay, at least they tell you which ones they're using. Eye serum, no. Ouch. Kind of expensive, but let's try this. You save 15% on all order. Just one? Just one. Auto adjusts routine over time, free express shipping, priority support, and free cancellation. I like that they give me the option to subscribe or not. I'm going to choose not to subscribe. Whereas with Proven, they pretty much forced me to subscribe, which I was not a fan of. I suppose that my biggest concern with yours is, are they really greenwashing or do they really actually care about the environment? I like the packaging, but is it actually going to be that easy to recycle? And then simultaneously, they're not shoving the clean marketing down my throat, but on the front of the page, it does say clean, vegan, and cruelty-free skincare. Are they going to be stocking this up with essential oils and irritating my skin and telling you that it's all natural? Or is it actually going to have good ingredients, feel luxurious on the skin, said dimethicone? We'll see. Do see Function of Beauty. I've actually already tried Function of Beauty, but I only tried two of their products. I did not get the moisturizer. Arguably, I like their skincare more than I like their hair care products. It was Beauty Within's fault that I tried them. It was Dr. Dre's fault that I tried the hair stuff. I'm gonna kind of use that experience as kind of like a baseline and judge these next products off of that. This one comes up next to Proven Skincare, and a lot of beautiful butterflies have actually asked me about this, but it's from a brand called Unique. And it says, uplift, empower, validate, unique, youology, it's about you. I like the idea that it sounds like it's about you. It sounds like it's all about women's empowerment. And it even says at the bottom that purchasing Unique products helps provide hope and healing. 10% of the profits from the sale of Unique products are donated to support survivors of child sexual abuse. I like that they're actually donating and raising awareness to something. I have confirmed that this brand is vegan and cruelty-free. But here's what's scary. A, it's expensive, but B, I'm pretty sure this is an MLM. Like, I'm pretty sure that I've seen this brand in the news before because of makeup that like somebody sued them over. Something about like an eye infection. But this is skincare. Is this the same brand? Oh. It is an MLM, aka a multi-level marketing company, which have been known for exploiting women and their communities. They're located in Utah, founded in 2012, but they are founded by a man named Derek Maxfield. I don't know. You can't judge a book by its cover, but his cover is just not selling me on it. When I Google Unique, an article from The Guardian comes up saying, they have you in a cultish grip. These women are losing thousands of dollars to online beauty schemes. This is scary. It specifically calls out Unique. I don't care if they're vegan and cruelty-free. I feel bad supporting a brand like this. And I feel like if I were to support or purchase from this and like give a woman or something a sale, that almost might encourage her to stick around for it. I feel like we need to dive into this even deeper. But until then, let me see if I purchase from the website, at least I'm not giving one person like false hope. Let's see.
Else isn't made for you. Introducing Uology, the skincare regimen mixed and made by you. Simply select your three.
Oh no, this is different. They're having you mix it in your bathroom. This isn't custom, this is you mixing it. What?
Targeted boosters to develop your own cleanser, serum, day moisturizer, and night cream. Experience healthier looking skin with a regimen you created. With up to 40,000 possible combinations, you can find your perfect fit. This is Uology.
At this price point, and the fact that they want you to like mix it yourself in your bathroom, sounds like highway robbery. You know what? Let me take the skincare quiz. So far, this quiz is also looking kind of like HTML 2.0. Like, it's giving me like late 90s vibes. What would you like to focus on? Pick at least three. Redness, loss of elasticity. Why is acne not an option? My main concern is not listed as a main concern. I'm feeling a little left out. Let's just go with enlarged pores. That's gonna be the closest thing. What products do I currently use? How come SPF is not an option? Do you want a tinting booster to transform your day moisturizer into a tinted moisturizer? Cool, but no. Do I have sensitive skin? I have erythema, so my skin is reactive, but no, it doesn't really bother me. How much exposure do you have to the following? Pollution? I don't know. Am I polluted? My brain is polluted. Medium? Sure. Sun? Well, what is low? Is low I'm a vampire, or is low the only sun I get is in the car driving to and from work? Give me some metrics here. Computer devices. Oh, I know that one's high. Do you normally get 8 or more hours of sleep? See, this is better because we actually have a quantitative value. Let's put sometimes. Do naps count? Do naps count? Customize your bundle. Oil control? Pore diminishing. I like that they say pore diminishing instead of pore reducing. Let's replenish, sure. Uology serum, firming. How come I don't have oil control? Where's the acne? Okay, fine. Firming, brightening. It's like all anti-aging wrinkle stuff. Like, I know who their target demographic is based solely on the options they are giving me. Wrinkles, I don't know, lines. Sure. Same thing. Okay, fine. Wrinkles, what? Fuck off. Okay. Daily moisturizer, environmental shield, that better be sunscreen. Oil control, time correcting. What is time correct? I'm just gonna choose time correcting. Yeah, is that a fancy way of saying anti-aging? I don't know. You can only select three. This one has the sketchiest graphics and it's also the most expensive, $202. And that is my bundled price. What is my name? Buckmeister Fuller. I can't even type Buckmeister Fullerene in because they only give me 10 letters. What if my name is more than 10 letters? It's really not that customizable, is it? Oh, I feel so bamboozled. Okay, fine, Bucket. Hey, at least they do have an animal testing promise. It says they don't test on animals. We strive to work with third-party manufacturers who share these values. That's really great, because it ensures that it's all throughout the world. Again, I'm getting like really sketchy typeform HTML CSS vibes just from this entire website. Bump it up a little bit. Oh! Night, it says wipe away your makeup with the Uology cleansing cloths. It died a little bit on the inside. Get to know your ingredients. Here's what I wanted. They gave me sunflower seed oil, which is great. It's just super basic. They're giving me aloe leaf juice, super great, but also super basic. Coconut fatty acid as a surfactant, excellent. But I don't see how that's customized. That's in like 50 to 70% of all of the moisturizers that you find at Ulta. The base has olive fruit oil. Is this just Jennifer Lopez? Just an MLM version? They force me to be in a subscription. I don't like feeling backed into a corner. Okay, the bottom of the website says, Better Business Bureau accredited and 100% secure. Why does that make me feel less secure? It literally does not allow me to continue without putting in a presenter. It says Unique is a direct sales company. Our products are typically sold exclusively through presenters who in turn earn royalties for every sale that they make. I don't want to give someone false hope. Visit our presenter map. Oh my God, you have to find a presenter in your area. Oh, or they want me to become a presenter. Right? Sign me up with like a $90 job application. I'm not the kind of person who backs down from things, but I'm also like, I don't want to give someone false hope. What's funny is that when I search for presenters in my area, but there is literally 3 presenters in the area. Like there's no presenters. Entry presenter, exemplary, elite, and exclusive. The fact that everyone is entry makes me think that no one is actually making money selling this shit. I don't know if it's shit yet. I'm going to test it before making that assumption. There's no one that's an exclusive. Everyone in these companies makes it out like they're making so much money. I literally can't find anyone who's in like, you know, the top tier black level purple exclusive. You guys, this just smells sketchy all the way around. Oh no, it shows me her face. This makes it so much more personal. You guys, I feel like I'm choosing someone to like hire a hitman on. And I know it's not that serious, but it makes me really uncomfortable. I'm so sorry, number 687. Sorry, if I ever see this person, I'm going to feel horrible. Like, I wish I could just give her money and be like, I'm sorry. Why do you make it so difficult to take my fucking money? Oh wait, that presenter is no longer active? Just check in with my body. This is making me physically uncomfortable. And I guess, you know, I'm putting the cart before the horse. I haven't actually tested it. Maybe it's gonna be great. Maybe this company really does treat their reps right. But just knowing that, you know, 99% of people go in and lose money and feel taken advantage of, that just makes me uncomfortable. So please note that this is not an endorsement. This is literally me testing this so that you don't have to. And I will give you my honest and authentic reaction and response to these products. A product is more than just how it works. Oh my God, it doesn't even let me put my zip code in. I'm a vegan, and when I smell a fish, I get suspicious. They force me to be a subscriber. Wait, look at these terms and conditions. To receive the above selective products at the frequency stated for the price, I agree to automatically be charged to my payment method on file. I will have at least 10 days notice. Cardholder consent is required. They require me to save my card details. Like, this is just making me a little bit uncomfortable. Like, there's a lot of red flags. This is the stress that those quizzes were talking about. We're so confident that you'll love it that we guarantee all of our products. We have made it hassle-free. Okay, if I still want to exchange or return my product, I can. That's good to know. Better Business Bureau accredited and Direct Selling Association. Let me just see what happens when I search Unique Better Biz Bureau. Ooh, they've been Better Business accredited since 2014. They're in Lehigh, Utah.
Oh my God.
Ooh, someone was a presenter with Unique, bought their convention ticket. They had to switch it to virtual. That's understandable. The brand had a response to this one and doesn't even address their complaints of the bullying accusations. It says, we regret that this presenter had a negative experience with the company. Again, pushing the blame on the victim. If the victim is, you know, I don't know this lady, but continue. The company takes allegations of bullying very seriously. Upon investigation, we were unable to find any reports or complaints of bullying submitted by this individual prior to her request to cancel the account. So they're admitting that they saw the cancellation and the issue, just nothing prior to that. At which time she mentioned she was leaving because of bullying, but didn't provide any details or proof. There's like a reason that MLM pyramid schemes are known for this. It appears her request to cancel her account was promptly granted. She was contacted by the company again, saying her account had not been canceled because she continued to receive emails. Terminating an email subscription is a separate process. We removed her email address so that she would stop receiving emails. Questionable. I ordered this company's products through an authorized representative, and it was a subscription to their cosmetics. I was unable to complete the purchase and sent a payment information to the representative who made the subscription. It took weeks to get my money back. The representative never canceled my subscription, which she only had access to, and then caused a second shipment to start. Oh my God, I again reached out to the company who promised a refund. Once again, it was not the full amount. After many days of emailing the company, okay, that's a little sketchy.
I read several more, or should I say dozens more, of dissatisfied reviews from customers who had issues with everything from shipping to returns to billing to customer service. It doesn't sound like this company makes it easy to return items or cancel orders. There were even several people who claimed that they were being charged for subscription orders long after they tried to cancel it. At this moment, what was going through my head is that I need to sign up for a burner credit card.
This is the same company that got sued for selling mascaras that caused eye infections. Apparently they lied about the ingredients or something. Let's see what Reddit says. Product question, has anyone used Unique/Uology Uplift Beauty Oil? What do you think? The one answer is MLM, stay away, with 8 upvotes. Now it has 9. Second person says, okay, one, it's an MLM, please don't support them. Two, it's overpriced, but the ingredients look fine. You can get all the same actives for cheaper. Three, can't say much on quality. It's an MLM, so I raise my eyebrows, but I don't think it's that bad. On the Unique subreddit, and it says a comparison of quality trusted skincare brand prices versus Uology, yikes. And they posted their regimen. They had to spend $251. Mine was less than that. Drunk Elephant was $232, so comparable. And they're saying for $59 less than Uology, you can get Laneige's entire winter break line. Yeah. I mean, I got truly customized skincare for less. They're making some great points. First Aid Beauty would be $161. Cause RX would be $91. Sincerely, a 15-year-old skincare freak. Who are you? I love you. You did your homework, baby. Are you a skintellectual? Are you part of the beautiful butterfly community? Because this is smart girl shit right here. Tiny Boss Babe for Jesus says, I took the Uology quiz and these scam artists are really trying to charge me nearly $250 without shipping for 5 products. What sucks is that you can get rose water spray for $5 at Ulta. Yeah, and they're charging you like $39? You can get the Mario Badescu spray for $7 and it's a better quality. Yeah, consult with a professional before use. Wow, no other brand has ever warned me to consult with a professional before using their products. There is someone who says that the mascara scratched their cornea, which, you know, in general, it's not what I'm looking for out of my cosmetics. I understand that's mascara and not skincare. Oh my God, this is on Reddit, and it says, another reason this company needs to be shut down. This person's eye is seriously infected. This is more than a corneal scratch. Oh my God. This is a straight up infection. Oh my God. Some distributors at the company are being very dishonest. What the fuck? Someone commented and said, they'll say that she was just applying it wrong. Exactly. And the fact that the lady sold you denying it was causing the problem is gross. Someone else said, oh, you mean I wasn't meant to jam it in my eye?
That is more than
a corneal scratch. Oh no. Hello, my name is Dr. Blankologist. Do you suffer from aging skin, wrinkles, fine lines, and an oily T-zone? There's literally someone who photoshopped their face onto a dermatologist's body and photoshopped the Unique products in here to sell. And it even has a disclaimer, I am not a doctor, but I am certified in Uology and can help you with your skin issues. Are you a licensed nurse? Are you a licensed esthetician? Are you at least a specialist who has worked at a counter like Clinique or something? Are you at least a makeup artist? I am so concerned. Has my credit card company contacted me about any suspicious activity yet? Okay, now we wait. I have coffee and me seester, and even though this stuff is customized for my face, we are going to give it some first impressions. As a reminder, these are our criteria, and this is a very antsy meow meow. Just looking at these packages, this is your first time seeing them all laid out. I kind of had a sneak peek. I just scanned through and I'm like, elegant.
eco-friendly and aesthetic. What is this?
Garbage.
I didn't want to say it like that, but you know, we're gonna test this on the formula. It's not just about the packaging and the first impressions. It's about how it works and the aesthetics of it. And that's what we're gonna get started with. So I guess let's start with Proven. Check this out. This comes with three different products. This was one of the more expensive of the bunch. I think it was right in the middle. What's also super cool is that it has this. It says skincare is as unique as you. And it actually has like my customized system. It has my name, it has my zip code. It basically has all my information along with my profile, my skin type, my sensitivity. Apparently my water hardness here is very hard. What are your first impressions on? It looks like we have a personalized cleanser, day moisturizer with SPF, and it looks like we have a personalized night cream.
I have high expectations for the formulation just because it looks, I mean, it's called Proven, so they seem confident in something.
They got that Shark Tank thing. So, my cleanser specifically was made in San Francisco.
Oh, that's metal.
Almost every single one of the main customized ingredients are in here and they seem to be at a good amount. So we're going to try out the cleanser last in the bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't need to moisturize my pants and the floor more than I already have. Okay, so next we have, this sunscreen. Yeah, I'm actually quite excited about this. This is a personalized day moisture with SPF.
Ooh, double whammy, okay.
It says, we made this product for you. It does say we considered your skin's needs and lifestyle. What's the active? Okay, so the active is zinc oxide. It's ocean 8 and coral reef safe. 8 approved sunscreen ingredient that protects against UVA and UVB rays. Zinc oxide is good. Titanium dioxide is good. I like a blend. It does look like a completely mineral sunscreen. SPF 50. I wish it said that on the front. We have squalane, plant-based. We have apple fruit extract. We have German chamomile. We have allantoin, which we love allantoin. I feel like water as the universal solvent should have been first. Maybe these aren't listed in order.
I feel like they can't be.
Zinc oxide. So these are not listed in order. The ingredients list does not tell you everything. But we're going to start out testing this one. Oh, that new pump moment.
Yeah.
There we go. Okay, and then wait. My nose is broken. Does it smell anything?
I don't smell anything.
That's what it looks like. Ready, set, swipe. It's looking a little white casty and it is a zinc oxide. It doesn't tell us what percent of zinc oxide it is. I'm assuming 10 to 20% just based on formulation. Let's see if this blends in eventually because we did have that Neopepto Nanoate in there that maybe is helping.
It's pretty white.
And that wasn't a lot, I would use twice that amount or three times that amount.
Yeah, if this is a moisturizer and SPF, you might have to use more than your...
Do you see a difference?
Yeah, that is pretty drastic.
We're gonna have to try this out over the next couple weeks, months, and who knows how long it's gonna take me to actually finish this video. That's kind of where we're at with this. For $145, I get that it's a customized sunscreen. My concern is FDA, is it actually customized? And then is this going to be Paste City Bitch or is it going to be Elbow Grease? Do you remember our SPF tier ranking? You can't forget the SPF tier ranking. You beautiful butterflies added to it, so. We really don't have anything to go on, so I'm just gonna stick it. This is my favorite, this is my least favorite. We're just gonna kind of stick it right in the middle. And then we can always move things around if we need to.
Yeah.
But we did also get the personalized night cream. This only has one fluid ounce as well. And let me see, this only has one fluid ounce. Usually sunscreens have 1.7 or more. So like, not hating, but it's not the most amount of product.
We're being critical
for your sake. Here. For you and your, for our $140, $70, for $200, yeah.
Do you need a tissue?
Can I get tissue?
Let me get you a tissue.
I'm dying. So this one actually seems very exciting, even though we don't have a ton of product in it. It was customized to me, it says, and it has vitamin D, which I love, sulfur, love that for acne, tea tree oil, love that for acne, the Gran Active Retinoid, but it's a proprietary Gran Active Retinoid, second gen, near prescription strength from Proven. So very interesting.
First ingredient is water. Then we do have squalane. We have lactobacillus ferment filtrate. We actually have a sea kelp bioferment. This almost feels like La Mer.
Sea kelp bioferment. That was the first thing I thought of.
Yeah, like La Mer, but not La Mer. It says non-sensitizing herbs and flower extracts. I bet you that's the fragrance. Shall we swatch?
We shall.
Swatch. Yeah, it doesn't smell like it. It's almost buttery.
I was gonna say that.
It's very oily. I told them I have oily skin, right?
It's like slick.
It's very oily, and I wouldn't, off the top of my head, think that this is what's recommended for an oily prone skinned person. But based on the ingredients, I'm not mad about it. I'm just gonna have to try it out. You have dry skin. What do you think of that?
If this were on my face, I feel like it would be a little too greasy for my liking.
We're just gonna put that as one step better. We still have the cleanser to go, but we're gonna be trying that in the bathroom. So let's dig into yours. Now yours was the most affordably priced. I got four products for $75, $79. It was normally $95, but they were on sale. Even Proven, those ended up being like $30 each. I was looking at the website, you can get these individually for $20. I liked that this brand is made in Switzerland. Switzerland has some amazing products. And normally when you buy Swiss skincare, like it's hundreds of dollars. And it's because they source really well. This also has the nicest packaging.
By far.
That's some really fancy packaging. Yeah. I got a day serum, a day moisturizer, and then a milky night cream and a milky night serum. My biggest thing with this one is that you couldn't take the fragrance out, and it is listed as fragrance, whereas the Proven one was not listed. It was like, oh, what does it say? Non-sensitizing herb and flower extracts. I'm like, okay, questionable. Let's see what we've got in here. I really like that they list everything with little pictures. That makes me really happy to like see the little pictures and the main ingredients. Looks like my Drop of Balance serum is the first one in the morning. It has salicylic acid for my acne-prone skin. We have Pinalumin, which reduces redness and calms inflammation. And again, these are ingredients that we normally see from Switzerland that I haven't tried. Let's try this one out. This is the Drop of Balance. So I am oily prone. This should technically balance me out. Oh, it's gel-like. That's and nice. I'm actually gonna put it on a different hand so that I'm not mixing it.
That has a nice light.
It's not overly floral. It almost feels like a toner in serum form. How would you describe it?
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it.
My initial impression is that the Proven one, like it actually dried in pretty silky. I feel like I'm going to move the Proven one up one better, and I'm going to put this one right in between. Let's try the moisturizer. This is the Matte and Moist Moisturizer. Oh, they are speaking my language. It says it has water as a first ingredient, the universal solvent. We have glycerin, propandiol, dimethicone, maltodextrin, niacinamide, polysilicone 11, saccharomyces ferment, citric acid, lactobacillus, a lot of prebiotics and probiotics. And when we actually look at what it says it was customized for me, we have Epidermis, which is a skin builder. It says inhibits pro-acne bacteria. This is a patented molecule. I am not familiar with it, but very excited about.
I've never heard of that either.
We have Sebosha, which improves pore structure and maintains oil balance. That all sounds like what I need for a day. My biggest pet peeve about this is that this does not have a sunscreen built in. They did sell a separate sunscreen that I did not get. I wish that it was built in, but is that a new product? I was almost expecting it to be white. It is like a gel. Wow. Speaking to my acne proneness. Do a little swipey swipey. You ready? 1, 2, 3. Swipe. I'm gonna move them all down one and then stick this one in the middle because the Proven one, I liked that it had a retinoid. But that's non-sticky, non-tacky. I feel like it would grip makeup well. It's not leaving me feeling oily or greasy.
Exactly. That's the part that I like about it the most.
And I am very oily, so this might keep me dry and mattified. Next, we get into the night stuff. This is the Drop of Light Serum for evening. So this night serum for me has Matrixyl. We love Matrixyl, patented ingredient. It's in a lot of The Ordinary's products. I already know that my skin likes it, so I love that they put that in here. We have Vital Ease. Again, all of this is patented. I don't know how they're doing this so cheap. What is the fill size on these? Ooh, this is a half of a fluid ounce. So this is even less than the proven one. So this is even less amount inside of the product. That is something to keep in mind because this was less expensive. This was 75 or 80 for four, which would have been 20 each, whereas proven was 50 each. But when you think about it, this ends up being 40 each if you double it. If you were to double the amount and make it equal to proven, because we need to work with equal metrics, this is $10 cheaper than proven. We do have Vitalease. It's a high strength retinol with no oily irritation. I love retinoids, so great. Amelox protects skin cells from oxidative aging, all things that I love. Let's try this. Ooh, nice. This one has a very distinct color. The smell is not bad. This is normally what like oxidized vitamin C looks like, but it doesn't look like there's vitamin C in here. This might be because of the retinoid perhaps. I like that the proven one had anti-acne in it, but I like that this one, if I were to double the amount and compare it to the proven, I like that it's better bang for my buck.
That dries nicely.
It does dry nicely. You see? Okay. We're gonna shift all of these one down. And then this, yeah.
Yay!
Night moisture. So this right here is the Milky Way night cream, but all of yours is cruelty-free. All of my stuff is vegan, which is great. This has water, it has sunflower seed oil, has cocoa caprylate, propandiol, betaine, dimethicone, all things that I really like. Again, really kind of nice base, and then it looks like we've added a lot of these filtrates. My specific additives are ruby extract, which improves blood circulation and gives skin a natural rosy glow. I have not tried a ruby extract. Poppy cells, very cool. Expo P protects skin damage from toxins and urban pollution. Now, normally when I hear protects from toxins, I'm like, shut up, everything can be a toxin. Like, your skincare is not toxic. This says protects from toxins and urban pollution. Urban pollution is a thing. Toxins, free radicals, ROS, reactive oxygen species, they are out there. Those can damage our skin. I like that it's not saying toxin free. The one thing about this brand is that they label themselves as clean, which I'm not a huge fan of. You guys know that. Their whole thing though is that they're defining clean differently because it's clean for the environment as well as apparently me. All right, let's try this.
Oh, whoa.
Whoa, that was ready there.
Okay. Did not hesitate.
All right, there we go. Oh, this one is the first cream one. Like the first cream one. Let's swatchy swatchy. That is buttery.
I do like that.
This feels like the proven one. It feels light. There is sunflower seed oil in here. Fine for acne prone skin like mine, but yeah, it feels a little bit, definitely not like the Day moisturizer. I like this. Question is, do I like it more or worse than the proven one? We're gonna give it some time on the face to figure it out, but for now, I'm gonna move those two up and this one down.
Man down.
Okay. There we go. Up next, we have the Uology, which I was really critical of these flimsy little Cracker Jacks.
Cracker Jacks?
Cracker Jacks. I agree, they look like something that I would cut out in like a school project if I was like 4 years old. They are nothing compared to the elegance and the beauty of these, but I have to give it to Unique. I was criticizing them really hard for not putting my name on the bottles. None of the other brands did either. So then we have
that.
Whatever you want to call this. Again, I've been spoiled by Function of Beauty.
We're going to have to kind of reset from the standard that gave
yeah,
us.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Honestly, their skin stuff is even better than their hair stuff. But that's not what we're here to talk about. Let's try this. I'm mad that I have to mix them in. Like, I'm salty. Again, like the proven one, we're gonna set this one and its little sample size packets aside. They're literally like sample size packets.
That's a lot of packaging to waste.
That is a lot of packaging. And they make me write the booster in myself. Like, what do? I use Sharpie? Do I use pen? Do I use human blood?
The blood of a Unique presenter.
Deceased. Oh my god.
You had to really really throw somebody under the bus just to get these.
I really did. I need to cancel my subscription.
And send a personalized apology to the person that you wrote down.
Yeah. Okay, there's... We're gonna do the cleanser last. Let's pick this up. I think we have to mix these. This is the you all, it's half. What the fuck? I'm so sorry.
That's like a, not even a third of the way full.
Please tell me you see this. I kid you not, this is how it came out of the box. I paid for, this was the most expensive one.
Feast your eyes.
This is, I haven't touched this at all. This one is only filled up to here. I feel like I need to set this down.
Even when you put all of, like, I know that they probably left room for you to put in the boosters, but even when you put all of the boosters
that's
in-
That's what it is! They left room!
But even Holy when you put the boosters shit. In, I can't imagine that it's going to compensate for that much missing product. Come on. I mean, it's still not going to be all the way full. They could have just not, you know? They could have just squirted
Holy
it into the-
shit! Do you see? And that's not even half full. Like, I paid $400 for this shit. And they're making me write it in on my own. Yo, was this used? No, this is a first pump, so it hasn't been used before. Oh.
Whoa. Ooh, that kind of smells like baby powder.
Yo, I'm sorry, she's not having... This was the most expensive one. The ingredients, we have water, glycerin, propylene glycol, dimethicone, all of that is totally fine. Olive fruit oil.
We know where this is going.
Y'all, why... Jennifer Lopez called, she wants her fucking ingredient list back. Look at this, they gave me every single ingredient for every single booster. There's nothing customized about this. They handed me the ingredients for every one and then they're just like, oh, find the booster that's yours. Wow. And for this much, you think that's gonna do anything? Okay, do you wanna hold that?
Oh, I'd be honored.
It's olive oil. That, a urine sample gives you more of a sample than this. I'm gonna put them all in together. Let's open it up.
They gave you the information for every booster every that's booster. Available for that product?
Even the ones that I didn't get.
Oh my God.
And is it just me, or is opening this, like, potentially for someone who doesn't know what they're doing, isn't it like, ooh.
Biohazard?
I mean, you could mix other stuff in here. Maybe people don't know what they're doing. I don't fucking know. I don't trust this shit. There we go.
These tubes are stupid. What if you can't get it all out?
That's how I feel. This is...
It's all gonna get stuck in the bottom and in those corners there.
That's how I feel. I feel like the ingredients in the retinoid one is the only one that I would go for. Like, that looks like a goopy mess. That's disgusting.
There's so much room for somebody to do this wrong.
Fuck.
-10 on the user experience.
This feels like a DIY gone wrong. Again, this is why we love preservatives in products. Preservatives stop things from going bad, but like even just that opening and closing makes me worried about contamination. I mean, we gave it a shake. It is streaky. Wow, that is streaky as hell.
Do they give you info on how long you're supposed to shake it for or anything like that? Or do they just say, figure it out. We got our money, we don't care.
It doesn't feel like there's anything on my skin, which is nice, but it also doesn't feel like there's anything on my skin.
Yeah. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Is that because it's great, or is that because it was literally water and it's now evaporated and it's just like on my skin? This is the Uology Day Moisturizer. Again, wants me to write in my own boosters. I'm putting this as trash right there.
Girl. We empty.
Like, you're kidding me, right? Water, dimethicone, canola oil? What? I fuck you not. Canola oil.
And then we have olive oil immediately following it. So what am I, a tilapia fillet?
Fine line corrector, oil control, and environmental shield protection. Okay, why are you giving me safflower seed oil in an oil control booster? Okay, we do have kaolin and silica. Slightly redeeming, but like, why even have this as an oil base? This seems like the same base for everything. The other booster is, what does time correcting even mean? What, is this going to make me revert back to pre-menses? Okay.
Oh my God.
Time correcting booster is, again, sunflower oil. It's the exact same thing for all of these, niacinamide. This one has retinol in it, I like, but it's identical to the other ones.
So wait, why is this oil control in a different packaging than that oil control? Why is this one the only one in a clear tube?
I don't know.
They kind of operate based on the assumption that their consumers are too stupid to ask questions about their skincare. Creamy.
These are like the Sephora sample sizes. I'm not into it. It's like a sad Pinterest DIY gone wrong. And then it's still not full.
Man, and that just sucks. It's not even anywhere near full, even with all of the boosters.
No. Like, not even close. So I'm gonna give you one side of the swipe. I'm gonna give myself the other side of the swipe.
Okay. I'm keeping my hopes high.
It's very liquidy.
Yeah, it feels a little thin to come out of a jar like that.
It feels just like the moisture.
It feels like the serum. And it smells the same too. The exact same.
It's got most of the same ingredients. Oh my God, yeah, it has canola oil and all. It's the same shit.
You know what? Check this out. I could have gone and stayed in a nice hotel overnight, taken one of the little sample size of the freaking body lotions out of the bathroom. I could have taken one of those home, gotten more product that probably smells better and is higher quality, and had that hotel stay for cheaper.
I haven't tested this on my face for a long time yet, but like, yeah, I'm not having fun. Stearic acid, olive fruit oil, carbamer, phenoxyethanol, shea butter. At least this one has shea butter for the night cream. Again, having oily, acne-prone skin, I do not feel like any of this was customized to me. Literally, more sunflower seed oil, olive oil. Again, not bad. Oh, we have urea. Okay, we have urea. Literally, why did you charge me this much for this? This is trash. Replenish. I'm angry at this point. Again, sunflower seed oil, glycerin, caffeine, ubiquinone, which is Q10. Okay, fine. But The Ordinaries gives me this for $5. Let's mix this in. They want me to use the same spatula, I guess. This feels heterogeneous.
Yeah, that doesn't look like it's gonna blend together super well. That is so chunky and nasty.
This looks like eggs. This looks like discharge.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
But it feels like shea butter.
Yeah.
And it smells just like the other ones. It literally feels like I put olive oil or canola oil on my skin. Angry. Okay, this is what we're working with. To the bathroom! Away!
Headband is on, and we are now going to try the two cleansers. We have the Proven, we have the Unique. I don't have any makeup on, but it doesn't make sense to wash my skin twice, so I'm going to try to do half and half. So this is my before face. That's what we're looking like. I have sunscreen on, and what is this? Vitamin C and sunscreen? That's it. We're gonna see how well this works. To start off with Proven, again, I really like that they did customize this to me. This actually looks pretty high quality. Azelaic acid, pre and probiotics, pomegranate extract, sodium PCA, which would be good for my oil control. Grapefruit extract, I wish that we didn't have this. I understand that they are saying it's a powerhouse antioxidant, but citrus, it's not my favorite for the skin. We have ginseng, we have green tea, we have Tasmanian pepper. And again, the very first ingredients are water, Panax ginseng, the Sipolis 400, which is patented, the Puri SSSLI, then azelaic acid, we have papaya enzymes, Papain, different seed oils, pomegranate extract, sodium. Yeah, seems pretty darn good.
The packaging is really nice. The main thing that I'm disappointed by all these brands, is the fact that they don't put my name on it. Function of Beauty really spoiled me.
Let's start with a damp face, just on this one side. Lovely. Nice.
Let's do a little bit of a pump pump. Oh, it's that new product moment. There we go. No exfoliating beads. Little bit tacky, kind of like a gel. Ooh, it does have a funny smell. Smell this.
I think it smells nice. It's kind of botanical.
I don't like it.
It almost has like a cough syrupy scent to me.
Yeah, like a medication-y. Yeah. It feels good. It's really not, no lather whatsoever. I feel like I should try it with makeup, and I will in the future, but I don't know. It almost feels gel-like. Like, it's very gentle. Yeah, really gentle cleanser. I'm like, would it break down makeup? I feel like I'm trying to wash my face with a cleansing balm or a serum. Okay, well, that's the face. Like, there's literally no lather whatsoever. All right, let's wash this off. I'm like washing one half of my face. That's so awkward. It's not stripping, but like I don't feel cleansed. My face is a little red. My face is a little red. I think that's the grapefruit. Citrus and I, could also be erythema. Feel my face. I don't feel super cleansed.
Yeah, that feels like it left a bit of residue maybe.
Feel the forehead? Yeah, it almost feels sticky.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is there a major difference? Yeah, this cleanser might not be for me. So this is nothing. This is proven. I get erythema, but it's not usually this bad.
Right.
Yeah, a little concerning. Should I be worried? Okay, well, we'll see what happens. Next, we have the unique one, and we do have to mix this before we can use it. So again, it's only filled about this much plastic. Like not full at all. See, where do I put this? Could you hold this? I don't know where to put this. Like, I don't want to get it dirty and put it on the sink. Like, how are you supposed to mix these? Okay, still red here. In this cleanser, the Uology cleanser. So for this cleanser, it looks pretty basic. We've got water, we've got sodium lauryl methyl isothionoate, we've got alkyl benzoate, sunflower seed oil, sodium chloride. Again, most of this stuff is totally normal, but we actually do have coconut fatty acid down here, aloe leaf juice. Like, there's nothing in here that feels like it was customized to me. It feels... Let's look at our boosters. We have pore diminishing, oil control, which is like half empty, and the replenishing nourishment. So... Pore diminishing has water, butylene glycol, glycerin, bark extract. What in here do you think is pore diminishing? Okay. Nah. Oil control. We have to look over elsewhere to even find it. Here it is, oil control. Water, sunflower seed oil. How are you telling me it's oil control when you literally have sunflower seed oil in it?
Glycerin, caprylic triglyceride, niacinamide, kaolin, and silica. Okay, so those are like the two things. That doesn't look like it has kaolin or silica. Did they even fill this properly? Like, kaolin clay, if there was any amount in it, it would give it more of a milky color. This is a clear gel. Maybe they know something, they do know something that I don't, but I am so confused. And then replenishing booster, again, safflower oil, glycerin, caprylic triglyceride. We have lactobacillus, which is nice, but everything else is just so basic. The more and more I read this, the more and more upset I get. Let's just mix these in. Also, this is looking better. Okay. There we go. There's like nothing in there. These small, like, knowing that this is mainly glycerin and sunflower oil, the small amount of whatever actives are in here, and then you dilute that into an even larger bottle. Oh, fuck. Just throw it all over the counter, why don't we? That's it? This is like the worst user experience I've ever had. Look at this, and I'm slopping it all down the side. This is really pathetic.
They don't care about making their customers happy at all. They just want to get their money.
They just want money. On a subscription-only basis. Yo.
Is it stuck? It's gonna explode.
I can't even get it out. It's like plugged with crust. Like, I'm trying. What the hell? Can you get this open?
I think you have to like clip the top or something.
I didn't have to clip the top on any of the other ones.
I know.
Is it the product that's stuck in here?
I can't tell.
I can't get it. What the fuck is going on? Yeah, could you get me scissors?
Yeah. I don't know what to do with that.
Thanks.
I think that might have been the design of what they sent you, but like, why the fuck is this?
They don't even say to cut it though. There's nothing that says cut.
Shall I snip it? There you go.
Okay, thanks. What a nightmare. I'm like, I'm afraid I'm gonna squirt it all over everywhere.
There's tons of residue.
This is a disaster. Okay, now, as you can see, the fill line has not substantially increased. How do I stir this? Do I stir it with this?
I think that spatula that I gave you is probably too wide.
What the fuck?
Good luck.
How am I supposed to do any of this? Do I just stick my grubby finger in there and fish it out? Oh my God, I'm pushing it further down.
You want like a chopstick or something?
Can you get me a chopstick? Okay. Fuck. Like, I feel like I'm like putting bacteria in the bottle. Like, this feels like a horrible idea. And now it's all greasy, so I can't even get this back on. I don't know how they want me to mix this. Oh, do they want me to shake it? They probably wanted me to shake it.
That's hella chonky. Okay, let's try to shake it, like the instructions say. I mean, how long do I do this for? It's not even beads. Normally there's beads or something that helps you mix. This is when we need parabens, so that my grubby fingers don't ruin something. Okay, there we go. So let's try this. Get a little bit of water in here. There we go. So this one foams up a little bit. This one just smells soapy. I mean, arguably it feels more like a cleanser than the Proven one. Proven one didn't feel like a cleanser at all. At least my redness and irritation went away on that side. I mean, arguably, it feels a little bit more like a cleanser than the other ones. It's kind of foamy, not overly foamy. You know, not overly strippy city. Let's wash it off. Oh, it burns my eyes. Oh my God, ow. Ow, okay. The Proven one didn't burn my eyes. Ow. Ow, hang on. That shouldn't burn. Ow, okay. Why is it burning my eyes? See, this is why, like, I usually cleanse my face in the shower. I end up throwing water everywhere. Oh, my eyeball. Okay. That's better. Ah, shit. I've soaked the bathroom. I mean, arguably, this feels more like a cleanser than the Proven one. Doesn't feel overly stripped. It lathered up nice. It just burned the hell out of my eyeball, which I don't think should happen. So, I feel like both of the cleansers were shit. First impressions only, this one didn't feel like it cleansed, and then this one like burnt my eyeball, even though it felt like it cleansed. Feel my face.
Yeah, it does feel less sticky than the other one.
Yeah, this one feels sticky. I feel like I'm going to need to try this stuff for a few weeks each. I don't have the time, space, or face space to dedicate to months at a time, but I'm gonna give them all a singular go and see what the experience is like, how it goes, how my face likes it. You know what? I'm still getting erythema on this side, but it's not as bad. There was almost something in the Proven one that irritated me. I should have done a patch test. I'm just gonna leave that there for like 5 minutes, see what happens. Eh. Proven to do what? Irritate my face? Okay, sorry. All right. I mean, now that my face is cleansed, I feel like we need to go in with a toner and a moisturizer and a serum. One last swipe of the face. This side doesn't even feel clean. This side feels arguably relatively clean, cleansed. It's just that my eyeball stings.
Yeah, this one feels like you've got a layer of something.
For dry skin, this would be stripping, but I'm oily. I don't feel overly stripped.
I would almost say the unique one, that one.
I think the unique one is better. I feel smoother on this side. This is sticky.
We've already looked at the ingredients of the proven ones. This right here is just my personalized day moisture. So for the next couple weeks, I'm gonna be giving this proven stuff a go. Just a cleanser and a sunscreen morning and evening. There's one fingerful. There we go. Hopefully that's enough. This is expensive stuff too. So it's like, I don't wanna waste it, but I wanna apply enough sunscreen. Two milligrams of sunscreen per centimeter squared of skin is the recommended. I always do two stripes on my fingers. That's what I do. And that's usually for this area and my ears. I've rubbed this in to the point that my skin is hurting. This is the normal amount of sunscreen that I would use. Two finger stripes is what I do. And I feel like I even went a little bit light because there's not a lot in this bottle. I don't feel like I could go outside with this.
You look ridiculous, I'm sorry, but.
I feel like even with elbow grease.
Yeah, the amount of work that you had to put in to get it to.
Do you see a difference?
I'm seeing that you're getting a little bit of irritation, erythema from.
Oh, I rubbed my face, so yeah. I feel like if you put in elbow grease, you can get some sunscreens to rub in. I feel like even with elbow grease, I don't know if this is rubbing in.
That's Paste City, bitch.
It is it pasty? Paste City, bitch.
You look pasty, though. Like, you almost look like you put on a layer of, like, foundation, but not the rest of your makeup, you know what I mean?
Do I look hella washed out?
Not hella.
Not
hella. But you look different.
I don't feel like this is worth $50, and I would prefer to reapply it throughout the day. Okay, well, I'll check back in and let you know how it goes. Rony bug, what do you think of my sunscreen?
Okay, love you.
Wee. Just took off. My headband.
You look like you're wearing a mask.
Do you see it?
Clear as day.
Is it bad?
It's bad.
Also, look, I washed off the cleanser and I'm red. I don't feel like I should have used that cleanser. Patch test. This is why you need to patch test. Do as I say, not as I do. Is it really?
You have an extremely distinct line. It's like somebody just drew around the edges of your face.
I feel like I
can't
go out.
There's a nice white line right there too.
I'm glad that we're in the middle of a panini, so I'm not going outside anyways.
I'd be embarrassed to be home alone and
see
myself.
What do I do? I know, like it doesn't make me feel pretty. I don't feel pretty. I just want to feel special. God damn. Duh. Wow. The whole reason I got skincare is because I wanted to feel special. And now I feel special enough in a good way. I don't like it.
You do the hard things for us so that we don't have to.
Can you rub in my line?
Okay.
Rona! Rona! You gonna rub in my line too? You rub in my line. I love you. Okay, I love you.
Ooh. I'm draining your lymphatic fluid for you.
Aw, thanks.
You're so welcome.
It's actually, but that's okay.
Okay.
I feel blessed. I feel stressed. I feel
not impressed.
Rona, what do you think?
I think belly rub.
Okay. Here's the real question. I feel like if I were using this brand on my own,
I would use this first impression and be so discouraged that I wouldn't go back for it again. Do I use it for like 3-4 weeks and just try to stick with it? Like, what do? Like, I feel like I'm happy. Look at this. Like,
yeah, that's, I don't feel can like you see should that? Subject yourself to that.
I feel like this would be a really bad idea for me to continue using. I don't know, like, so, do I continue giving this a try? Because I feel like the sunscreen was a bust. I feel like the cleanser I shouldn't use. Do I stick with the night cream for like 3 weeks to give it a try? If I were doing this on my own, I would have this first experience and I'd be like, I don't want to try that again just based off of a first impression.
This was a fail, that was a fail. Maybe we try the night cream and see how we feel, and if it's the same sort of in your face, oh my God, that's not good, type of reaction, then we will have our verdict.
Okay.
But I really don't think you should continue using that. That's not good, Juju.
No, Juju.
It's blended out now. When's the funeral for your bank account?
Shut up. For $150, the packaging is nice, but like, holy shit.
That's like some of the holy most expensive shit. Disappointment I've ever seen you pay for.
That's a big expensive disappointment. Like, I mean, I got 3 products, so it was like $50 per product. That's not ridiculous.
Yes.
Wish me luck.
So I've been testing these out for literal months. I have some final thoughts. I keep on putting on the Unique cream, again, very upset that they don't have a day sunscreen. I think it's irritating my face. Well, as a reminder, these are our criteria, and this is what I'm going to be judging each brand off of and kind of seeing how they stack up. As a reminder, pink is the worst because I just don't like pink that much, and purple is the best because, I mean, I'm not a purple person. But if purple were a person, I'd be purple. So we'll start off with proven skincare. Does it work? One of my biggest reservations when it came to this line was that they were so hyped on like Shark Tank, and I was wondering, are they really worth the hype? And it got to the point where the cleanser irritated my skin right off the bat, so I haven't even been able to use this. I was pretty disappointed by that, and I understand that that's not necessarily the brand's fault, but for being customized skincare, I would have liked the opportunity to just like, remove the grapefruit or remove the fragrancing component that I could potentially have an irritation to. So the cleanser, I don't really know if it worked because I literally wasn't even able to use it. So we're just gonna throw that off into yonder. The sunscreen, did it work? I mean, it did technically protect me from the sun, but it was Paste City, bitch. Like, it was borderline Mark Zuckerberg Paste City. And I didn't feel like I could wear this out. I felt like no amount of rubbing it in would work. It was pretty bad based on, you know, the efficacy portion. So that would be down here probably. The personalized night cream, I did actually enjoy. It was kind of weird. It's like an oily texture, but someone on Reddit had said it felt like a greasy hand cream. I kind of agree. But it wasn't a bad thing. This wasn't something that I could wear throughout the day, but for night, it actually wasn't horrible. And again, the ingredients that they put in there for me were actually pretty spot on to what I needed. It wasn't the best texture, but considering all 3 of these were like $150 and that this alone came to like $50, you know, I was actually fairly happy with it. So based on efficacy, I'd kind of put it here. But remember, it's not just like, did it work or how did it work, but it's also the formulation. Sunscreen was just absolutely awful. It didn't blend in, didn't soak in. Was it effective? Probably. Actually, efficacy might have been over here. It was just horrible to use from an experience perspective. And then as far as this one, I really enjoyed the ingredients. Based on the cleanser, I did like the ingredients. So if I were able to use it, it would probably be somewhere up here as well. But unfortunately, I feel like I have to veto it because it wasn't a fit for me. The one thing that I did dive into when it comes to proven was actually the formulation. And I actually spoke to some beautiful butterflies. I had our potato wives fill out the proven skincare quiz and see what ingredients they got. And we all had different skin types, and some of us came up with very similar ingredients. And when we actually compared the main formula, this doesn't look as purely customized as they claim it to be. They basically use a base formula and then they're dropping in those active ingredients. Now, that is very interesting. I still feel like these were customized to my needs and I feel like that was pretty good. But it was very interesting to see the results that our other community members and butterflies got. It's not like they're mixing a completely custom formula for every single person, and specifically the sunscreen that goes through FDA approval. A lot of people got the exact same ingredients. Is it an enjoyable experience to use? This was frustrating because for all three of these, not so much. I'm being a little bit harsher and a little bit critical for the moisturizer. Based on these were absolute trash to use for me. I was not a fan of them. But, you know, as far as the moisturizer goes, for a night moisturizer, it wasn't bad. I think the ingredients were the best part of it. And then, was it enjoyable? It wasn't the worst moisturizer I've ever used and it wasn't the best, but it was pretty high up there. Then what about the worth, the affordability, the accessibility, the price point? Proven was pretty darn expensive, but it wasn't the most expensive. Again, you get three products for about $150, $170, and that ends up coming out to a little bit more than $50 a product. Is it accessible? I actually don't know if they ship international. They came very quickly, which I appreciated, and they do seem accessible as long as you can afford it. I do wish that you could purchase these without the subscription, and I do wish that you could purchase these like more individually, but you know, being custom skincare, I understand why that may not be feasible. Now, one thing, when I was trying to cancel my subscription, it was a little bit difficult, but they didn't make it impossible. They asked me why I wanted to leave, and I was just like, the sunscreen don't work, and the cleanser made my face red. It wasn't the easiest, but it wasn't the worst experience. And I feel like at least they weren't trying to dupe me. They were trying to get good feedback that maybe they could use to improve the product in the future. I don't think it's worth the hype that Shark Tank gave to it, but it's not bad, and I think they're onto something. So would I buy it again? If they changed a few things or if they made it optional on whether to include fragrances or if they asked you about allergies and maybe they could like leave some of those compounds out of it or you could like X out of a compound if you didn't want it, that would be amazing. And yes, I would buy it again. For $50 a product, that's not ridiculous. That's what you find at Sephora. I'm pretty okay with that. Problem was that the sunscreen was horrible. I would not buy the sunscreen again since there are many other options at the same price at Sephora that work much, much better. The cleanser, you know, if it had the same ingredients but didn't irritate me, the probiotics in here, yeah, I would give this another shot and I wish I could have used this more. For the moisturizer, yeah, I would buy this again. It's a Grand Active Retinoid Moisturizer. It has some good supporting ingredients. It has vitamin D, which I really appreciate, tea tree, all things my skin loved. And I would actually pay like $70 for the moisturizer if I had to. So that kind of helped to offset the cost of everything here. But again, Shark Tank really hyped this up. I hope that they take my cancellation feedback seriously and like kind of, you know, create a few better options for us in the future. So next, what about yours? This is the one that I was skeptical of because there were like no reviews. There didn't seem to be a lot of feedback online and the only kind of commentary was actually on the brand's website. They seem to use real before and afters. It looks like they're not Photoshopped. However, brands can manipulate reviews on their own websites and I naturally get skeptical. This got to me quite nicely and I was actually blown away by the box and the packaging. Their focus on sustainability seems to be pretty good. The box looked recyclable, all of the little components were recyclable, and I actually went back and I purchased another product. I purchased the cleanser. Don't have the sunscreen still, but this is actually amazing. I wish that I had gotten this from the beginning or that I had gotten a bigger kit because this was actually bomb diggity. I'm thinking of going back to try to get a toner and a couple of other things as well. But for yours, yeah, the biggest concern was the lack of reviews. Like, how new are they? Why aren't there reviews? How come nobody is talking about this? But so far, I used this one for over a month and a half, almost 2 months. Very interesting results. So do it be work dough. We're talking about the efficacy on my skin, but also kind of, you know, the brand's ethics. As far as what they claim when it comes to the pumps, the recyclability, yeah, I would say like 8 out of 10 met my expectations. Does it work on my skin? Yeah, my skin is oily and acne prone. These were gel moisturizers and gel serums that I really, really liked. The night moisturizer was a bit more fluffy, which I really appreciated for the evening. I mean, were they absolutely spectacular? I don't feel like they transformed my skin, but they were really nice experiences and I genuinely enjoyed them. I found that they layered themselves well together and I actually found like, wow, I'm doing 3 steps in a routine, you know, on like a self-care day. Yeah, I've been known to do 5 or 6. And that was kind of nice to kind of just go back to basics and keep it simple. So how's the formulation? How are the ingredients? I was really impressed by these. I do think again that they're using like a base formula and dropping things in, but what I liked is that they really explained quite well exactly what ingredients are in there. And a lot of these are patented molecules, which is interesting and normally extraordinarily expensive. These are also made in Switzerland. Swiss skincare is coveted around the world because they have really great actives, really great manufacturers. They're doing stuff right, but normally you have to pay $200 for 1 bottle of serum, which is why it's not accessible to most people. I found that the ingredients were formulated relatively well. They seemed to work on my skin nicely. I did see improvement in some of the little areas that I have down here and some of the little sebaceous filaments that I get when using the gel moisturizer, which was nice. And again, the milky moisturizer that is vegan that I put on in the evenings, it made my skin feel plump and supple. And I do like that they heavily explain what epidermis is, so that I know exactly what I'm putting on my skin and kind of how it's working. The ruby extract, the poppy cells. I feel like I don't see a lot of other brands using these patented ingredients, and that was really, really cool. The one thing on formulation that I'd wanna go back and ask about is the drops of light serum. When this actually comes out, it is really this nice amber color. Now this is how it arrived to me, and I don't know if this is the color of the serum or if this is something that oxidized. You see, vitamin C is relatively unstable, and when vitamin C oxidizes, it can kind of turn a brownish color. I don't believe this is oxidized because it stayed the exact same color the entire time I've had it, but that was something that was just different for me, seeing as all of the other serums were just a regular gel or just like a regular moisturizer. So it still blends in very nice. It doesn't leave my skin looking orange and that color kind of goes away, but that was just something that was interesting to me. So what about the enjoyability of the experience? The quiz online was relatively good. I could see it being a little bit confusing for some. I liked that they asked my zip code. Seeing as these were made in Switzerland and customized to me, I was expecting them to take a lot longer to come than they did. I really, really enjoyed these. The products feel nice. They're packaged very well. I don't love this color. I wish that I could choose my color. I like the purple one. And this is just really nice. Like, it looks good on your vanity. And again, I actually went back and I got the Cloud Cleanser, which, oh my God, this is a literal cumulonimbus. So up next is affordability, which does matter. This was actually the least expensive set in the entire testing of this stuff, which is kind of shocking because you do get 4 products. Now, this is where you have to look at fill size. The fill size on these are a little bit smaller. Again, I used mine for 1.5 to 2 months. I found that this amount of product worked for me, but if you are very, very generous with the amount of products that you use, if you use products like most TikTokers and most reviewers do, you're gonna run out of these way too quick. They had a smaller fill size, which is why they're able to charge less. But especially for customized skincare, $75, $100, especially if you are able to get like one of those discount things, really, really impressive. And again, the one thing that I loved about this brand that none of the other brands offered was that you're able to purchase these products on their own. I could purchase the cleanser without having to sign up for another subscription package. It was easy to cancel the subscription. They didn't make me feel like they were trying to lock me into something. Yeah, this was done really well. It exceeded my expectations. And they're also cute. They're affordable. I was really happy with these. So would I buy it again? Yes, I would purchase these again. I don't know if I would purchase the drops of light serum. It was good, but it wasn't my absolute favorite. The drops of balance I loved. I felt like this really helped to wick away oil on my nose and forehead, which my oily face needed. The moisturizer was good. If you're dry, you're not gonna like it, but I'm oily, so it worked for me. And then the night moisturizer, it didn't feel suffocating, but it was really, really pillowy on my face, which I love and appreciate. And just the fact that this brand cares about sustainability, they have the airless pump, they teach people actually how to work with their product and how to recycle it. I know it takes a lot of extra work, but little things like that matter to me. So yeah, I would definitely do this one again. I would put the drop of light serum maybe around here. It was decent. I would put the drop of balance serum probably up here. I loved this for my skin. The Milky Way night cream, this far surpassed my expectations, and I would say this is probably one of my favorites. That was Yeah, that was really, really nice. It wasn't overly greasy the way the Proven one was. That was golden. That was bomb. And then the matte and moist moisturizer, it was pretty good. Again, not as good as the serum for like the oil wicking properties. And I really like my stuff to have a lot of actives, which this had some, but it wasn't like blowing me out of the water. So, yeah. Yeah. Then we have Unique, Ology, Uology. You know where this is going. The line as a whole doesn't work. No, it makes you work because it makes you like mix everything in. I was sorely disappointed with this. I would say, does it work? The cleanser actually worked the best for me, but the bottle doesn't work. That little stick inside kept on breaking off even when I tried to pump the product. So there were days that I just had to smash the bottle onto my hand to even get product out. This one did work relatively well for me. It removed makeup, didn't like overly irritate my skin, which was pretty good. But you know, it wasn't my favorite out of all. This one was a sad, sore disappointment. We'll talk about the ingredients in a second, but this just felt very greasy. It also doesn't work in the bottle. Whatever they had me mix in didn't actually mix in. You can still kind of see it separating if you don't shake it before each use. I was not a fan of this, but I don't think it destroyed my skin. Now, the night and day cream, those are different situations. The night cream was arguably almost like the cleanser. It was actually kind of a favorite in a way. I like that they made me add the retinol to it, but I don't know how much it worked. I didn't see major differences. You know, it looks like discharge, like I'm just saying. I can't look at it without thinking that. I hope you know, that's all your fault. So, is it a moisturizer? Yeah, it's a moisturizer that sits on your face. Now the day cream, not a fan of. Again, that's what I've got on right now. There's something in here that is irritating me. Not to the point that I have to get rid of it, but like every single time I would use this, I would see my face start to flush. And I was like, that's really concerning. And again, the ingredients are pretty subpar. I didn't find them to be extraordinary. I feel like I got a couple little breakouts with this one. Maybe it was the olive oil. This was just not for me. And I don't feel like it worked, and I don't feel like this was customized to my skin. But let's actually talk about those ingredients, right? How are the ingredients on the cleanser? Confusing. It was supposed to be oil controlling, pore diminishing, and replenishing. I didn't feel any of that. I would argue that the ingredients on the cleanser felt the nicest on my skin, didn't bother me. I know I'm critical, but like it wasn't my least favorite. It is a plastic bottle, but the ingredients on this one were slightly better. I mean, it's a cleanser. It wasn't the best, but it actually wasn't horrible. So I would kind of put it there. The serum, oof, the ingredients on this I despised. It's the firming booster, the line minimizing booster, and the wrinkle reducing booster. I don't feel like it did any of that for me. The ingredients separated out, I don't feel like whatever it was in here was supposed to be in here and mixed together. It didn't do what I was expecting. It kind of irritated my skin, not in a way that like made my skin flush. But you know what, now that I think about it, I did use this along with the day moisturizer, so maybe it's something that's in here that's being combined. This was a sad, sorry excuse for a product. I don't know if I would put it here. Based on the night moisturizer, again, I have a real big vendetta at the fact that they made me mix all this crap in together. The ingredients that they chose for me were slightly better on this night moisturizer. They had the hydrating booster, they had the puffiness reducing booster, and the replenishment booster. I don't feel like it helped with puffiness. Was it replenishing? It felt like a night moisturizer. It was a little goopy, wasn't the best to use, was nothing compared to the other brands, but I mean, if I bought this at CVS, I wouldn't be mad. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, catch an MLM by its toe. If it hollers, don't let them unsubscribe, because yeah, they didn't let me unsubscribe. I still haven't been able to cancel. They are literally holding my money hostage, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to call my credit card company. Anyways. The day moisturizer. This one was supposed to have an Enviro Shield booster, oil control, time correcting. This was absolute garbage. It made my skin greasy. There was not oil control in here. There was literally olive oil in here. And I feel like it either irritated my skin or caused some of this redness and blemishes in combination with this serum. This was just trash. No oil control, there's no sunscreen in it, and if it's a day cream, like I would hope that that's what they're using to prevent against environmental damage, I'm like, what is this? And it's like Pinterest DIY gone wrong. that was disgusting. I hate that day moisturizer. So that brings us to the user experience. And this was not even, like, this is like off the charts, like throw it on the floor. The experience for this was treacherous. The website didn't make sense. It took forever to get to me, even though that might be on me because I left it in my mailbox for a hot day. Having to mix this in together, maybe I should have read the website better, but seeing as this was like the most expensive one, they made me do this myself. It was a horrible experience. The knobby thing keeps breaking off. This was absolute trash. Like I'm critical of it, and maybe I have an implicit bias and I'm trying to work around that. But like, if I just think about my experience, like this was absolute garbage. The night cream looked like discharge. So that was not enjoyable to look at, but it was arguably one of the more enjoyable ones to use because I was asleep and closed my eyes and didn't have to think about it when I was dreaming. Really bothersome. And then this one, day moisturizer. It was like the opposite of what they claimed. It was not made for my skin type. This is absolute trash, and I think that it's irritating my face slowly but surely. And these combination, I think, are giving me these little breakouts and just like this nastiness all over the place. This was so unenjoyable. What is this? Like, look at this. This was the most expensive one, and yet the other ones did such a better job on like their pricing, their marketing, et cetera, like everything. This is literal trash. And then they didn't let me unsubscribe. I tried to go to the website and say, hey, like, you know, this was really expensive. I don't want to spend $200 to $400 on this shit every single month. Like, I'm not going to be using this again. They're holding my money. I am very, very deeply concerned. This one I've only used for about a month, and like, they've either already charged my card again or they're going to in like a day or two. So I feel like I have to call my credit card company and say, stop, halt, don't do this, because they are literally forcing me into a subscription that I don't want, and I legit do not know how to cancel it. Like, this is a nightmare. Life is busy. Take the work out of it for me, and you're making me do more work. Literally mixing things together and making me do more work. I'm sorry. I'm really upset. It feels heavy and luxurious. It's not. Like, this is a scam, allegedly a scam. And again, what I have found out about this company and their fake charity since, and I'm not the only one who has had skin irritations from this brand. I've interviewed someone. It's gonna take another 6 months for me to get this video out, but let me tell you, it just keeps getting worse and worse and worse. This is not unique. This is useless. Speaking of, what is the affordability? Not. This was the most expensive thing. You're gonna have to expect to pay $200 to $400 to mix this shit on your own. You're looking at $50 to $70 per product, and they don't let you cancel. Tell me how that's affordable if I can't choose when I'm getting my product. Like, this is not okay. And also the fill size, arguably, I think this had the larger fill size of them, but I feel like you have to use so much because it's watered down olive oil. I don't feel like you're getting any of the actives that you're paying for. It's not affordable. It's a joke. It's a scam. Allegedly, don't sue me. Yeah, I'm deeply regretting this purchase, and like, I'm like kind of stressing about having to call my credit card company because I don't know how to quit. Like, I don't know how to get them to stop billing me. Would I buy it again? Is that a joke? What kind of a question is that? The audacity of this ranking system to even question me. Absolutely not, unless I'm doing this, you know, to test it out or to explain an experience. Even from the get-go, like, you guys, I'm kind of frustrated with myself. Like, I should have listened to my gut instinct. This is an MLM. It's a business practice that I don't agree with. Why did I go through with this? Like, was I really expecting anything good to come out of it? I'm trying to give it the benefit of the doubt, but I have maybe an implicit bias. I absolutely would not buy it again, would not recommend it. Disgusting. Again, this is probably one of the better ones. Still trash. This is absolute garbage. This is absolute garbage. Like, get the fuck away from my credit card. Hide your kids, hide your wives, hide your wallet, because they're trying to get everybody to sign up for their little MLM scheme out here. So, if we're to rank these, in respectivity, is that a word? Respectivity?
Respectively.
That to the others. Where do they belong? We'll start with this one, Proven. Honestly, if I could use this cleanser, I would be very happy. I just can't. I'm gonna put it right in the middle because It was a pretty good experience on the website, but I just can't speak to the product. Based on their sunscreen, not a fan. It was pretty paste city. At least it was a sunscreen. At least they offered a sunscreen. I would put it kind of like maybe right here about. The moisturizer, it was my favorite out of what we have, but it wasn't my favorite out of everything. I'd actually probably put this kind of right up here. You know, wasn't bad. It was kind of like greasy hand lotion, but for night, I don't really mind it. Then we have yours. I do wish that I had gotten this and the sunscreen off the bat. I'm very excited to continue testing this brand. Again, it was January, February that I first got the stuff. I would say that the Drops of Light Serum was my least favorite from this. Maybe I'd put it right here because I actually did like this from Proven a little bit better. This Milky Way Night Cream. Oh my God. I don't know if I put it here or here. I feel like this was my favorite product out of the entire bunch. It was the most affordable. It was from the favorite brand experience that I had. I'm gonna put this right up here. Oh, the Drop of Balance Serum. This was really good. I loved it. And as far as the day moisturizer goes, I wish this were a sunscreen. I understand they have a sunscreen. My fault for not buying it. I'd kind of put it here. I feel like it was slightly better, but like it wasn't as good as this one. So like they could kind of share a spot. They could kind of share. They're kind of comparable, only one was a better price and a better experience. But formulation wise, yeah, formulation with a grain active retinoid, it just, there you go. Happy little family. Then we have Unique, which was, again, not unique, but completely useless. This is a disaster. Like, can you give something an F minus? Can you give it like a Z? This cleanser arguably worked the best. Didn't like the brand, but it actually worked better than the sunscreen from Proven. So like brand ethics, morals, and values, it goes down here, but like efficacy of product kind of goes right there. This was again, trash, gross. Oh, actually this was probably my favorite. This was the night cream. I'd almost have these two like share a spot. They're just gonna kind of hang out there together. And then this was actually even worse than the serum. I feel like it was breaking me out. This and the serum in combination were just trash. It goes down here. So when it comes to this debacle of customized skincare, what are the overall thoughts? Based on what I found out, what I've learned and what I've tested, I feel like custom skincare still has a way to go. It doesn't feel as truly customed as you want it to be. Some brands like Proven and yours do better, but some like Unique are just like jumping on the trend to try to steal your money. What I almost wish there was is like this a la carte system where you can like drag and drop the ingredients you want or the scents that you don't want. I love cosmetic chemistry. I love the biology of our skin. I understand why that might not be ideal for everyone because like if you're given, you know, all of these ingredients, how are you supposed to know which one does what and if it works? But I feel like having the option to include or exclude something would be really nice in these brands. I really liked that yours didn't make you sign up for a subscription. I wish that all of the brands had the option to just purchase products on their own. However, Proven was relatively easy to cancel. Yours was easy to cancel, which was nice. This I'm still struggling to cancel my next subscription for, so that's gonna be a nice nightmare. And customized skincare, I feel like there are other brands that we haven't tried. It's a great concept. Execution could be a little bit better, but like, you know, considering this experience versus just going to a drugstore, and the price points, especially like $20 for some of these, maybe $50, you know, it doesn't break the bank. It's no longer $700 for something that is really tailored to your skin. So beware of MLMs, be a critic and a skeptic. If you've had an experience with these products, please tag me on Instagram with your custom formula. I wanna compare formulations and see a little bit deeper into what other people are getting who have different skin types. And if you're not subscribed, this video took legit months to put together, multiple days of editing, an entire group of wonderful, amazing people that worked alongside me on this, and a shit ton of money that I should not have spent. So by pressing the like button or subscribing or sharing this video with a friend or just watching the ads that YouTube puts on it when they come through, every little bit does help. Thank you. Do not do Unique, but do remember to be beautiful both inside and out. I love you beautiful butterflies and your lovely stratum corneums, and I cannot wait to see you in the next video.
Love you guys. Bye.